Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and this is the second chapter on OpenShift tutorial. In this video, we are going to install and configure OpenShift Origin 3.11 on CentOS 7 machine. We are going to use three machines. One is master, second is compute, and third one is infra. So let's begin. I am ready with three machines and all three machines are pingable from each other without modifying local etc host file. Let's try to ping. I can ping master machine from compute machine. Similar way, I can ping compute machine from infra machine. If you need any assistance to set up those machines with nip.io DNS, then you can watch this video on my YouTube channel and complete the instruction for all three machines. Once you are ready with three machines, come back to the installation process. Let's install the OpenShift Origin package on all three nodes. Don't worry about the long command. I will add all the command in text file. Install the same packages on compute and infra machine. Let's update those packages on all three machines. It has been completed on all three machines. Now let's talk about network manager service. The network manager service should be enabled and run on the machine to set up the network between containers and host machine. Resolve.conf file is managing by network manager service. Let's look at the content of this file. Since I am using open source DNS service and local ISP name server, hence I need to modify this file to support the OpenShift installation. This file is getting overwrite with default value by the network manager on every restart of network manager service or system reboot. To stop this behavior of this file, we require to modify files in few locations. First, we require to modify networkmanager.conf file. Add this line in the file and save the file. Complete same step on remaining two nodes. Second file we require to modify is your Ethernet file. Go to that location and find your Ethernet file. This is my Ethernet file. Let's confirm it. You can see here, this is my virtual Ethernet card ENS33. Edit this file. Add two lines in the file. PDNS say yes and DNS1. Consult with your network team. Get a list of official DNS name and add DNS in this file. Go ahead and save it. Complete same exercise on remaining two machines. I have successfully edited ipconfig file on all three machines. Now restart network manager service one by one on all machines. Now let's modify the resolve.conf file with the correct information. Remove the line generated by network so that we can know who modified this file. Just keep root domain here and change Google name server. It should be your organization name server. I'm using Google name server for the demonstration. Let's go ahead and save it. Complete same exercise on remaining two nodes. Now restart network service on all three nodes and confirm the resolve.conf file content. Yes, name server is not overriding by network manager service. Let's confirm on remaining two nodes. Yes, perfect. Now reboot all three machines. Now install and enable EPEL repository on all three machines. Now install Docker on all machines. I am installing Docker 1.13.1. Yes, Docker 1.13.1 successfully installed. Running on compute machine. Now working on infra machine. Done on all machines. By default, Docker use ephemeral storage for containers and images. It means that data will lost when the container is removed. We need persistent storage for the Dockers on master, compute and infra machine, because by default web and etcd containers are getting created on master machine during the installation. If you remembered, we added second disk on each machine during CentOS 7 Linux machine installation. Let's verify. Yes, we have two disks, SDA and SDB. We will use SDB volume for Docker's storage. Let's configure the Docker storage setup configuration file. This is the second disk name and this is the name of volume group. Save it. Edit this file on all the node. Now run the Docker storage setup utility. You can see in the info, persistent storage has been configured for the Dockers. Apply same changes on remaining two nodes. It is done. Now start and enable Docker service. Check the status of Docker service. Yes, it is active and running. Super. Now install the Ansible on master machine. Check the Ansible version. By default, Ansible 2.4.2 installed. OpenShift Origin 3.11 doesn't support Ansible 2.4 version. We require to upgrade Ansible version above 2.4 and below 2.8 because OpenShift Origin 3.11 doesn't support Ansible 2.8. Let's remove the Ansible 2.4 on this machine. Let's install Ansible 2.7 from the RPM. Yes, Ansible 2.7 has been installed. We require to set up Ansible only on master machine. Now let's create SSH key on master machine and copy on remaining two nodes. Key has been copied and now you should be able to log in on compute and infra machine without password. Yes, we are connected to infra machine. Now we are connected to compute machine. Now we all set to install and configure OpenShift Origin 3.11. Now we require to create a Ansible inventory.ini file. I have created a simple inventory.ini file with minimum parameters. Let me explain this file. It starts with OS EV3 group with member of masters, nodes, and etcd. This is the common variable. We are going to run the Ansible playbook with under root privilege. We are using OpenShift master default subdomain and we are pointing to wildcard DNS entry of infra machine because router and default registry is going to install on infra machine. Subdomain should always pointing out on the machine where OpenShift router is running. Deployment type will be origin. These are node variables and we are disabling checks on disk availability, memory availability, Docker storage. These are master variable and we are disabling checks on disk availability, memory availability, and Docker's storage. By default, login in OpenShift is disabled. By using these parameters, we are enabling HT password D authentication. In the master group, we are using the IP address of master machine, etcd key value installed on master machine. This machine is designated to install master components. This machine is designated to install compute components, and this machine is designated to install infra components. Let's create inventory.ini file on the master machine. Save it. Now let's clone the OpenShift origin source code. Let's check out the OpenShift origin 3.11 release. Okay, before starting the OpenShift origin deployment, let's complete the last checksum. Open the SE Linux config file and make sure it should be uncommented along with this parameter. Verify this on remaining two nodes. Go ahead and save it. Now we are ready to install OpenShift origin 3.1. First, we require to run prequisit playbook to make sure all the components, file and folders, permissions and other settings are installed on all machine for OpenShift origin installation. Let's go ahead and play it. It is going to gather facts. This process can take 5 to 10 minutes to be completed. Prequisit successfully completed. Now time is start OpenShift origin deployment. Before starting the OpenShift origin deployment, please make sure that all three nodes should have internet connectivity. Now play the deploy cluster playbook on master machine. It can take 30 to 40 minutes to be complete. Watch the logs very closely and don't omit any warning or error messages. Well done guys, OpenShift origin successfully installed without any warning or error message. Let's try to access OpenShift origin web interface. You can access OpenShift origin web console on master, hostname or IP address followed by 8443 or 443 port number. It is self-signed certificate error message. That's okay. OpenShift origin by default installed with a system admin user account. Let's change the password of this account so that we can log in web console. Go to master machine and change the password of admin account. Password has been changed or added for admin account. Let's try to log in now in OpenShift Origin web console. We are successfully able to log in OpenShift Origin web console, and we can access all service catalogs. I can access cluster console also. Click on cluster console and I can manage ports, deployment, cron job, replica set, networking, storage, and all administration tasks from the cluster console. I will create a separate topic to walk through of OpenShift web console along with cluster console management. At this moment, we have successfully installed and configured OpenShift Origin 3.11 on our CentOS 7 local environment. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.